Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome back to our channel. It's your boy Jesse Keegan,
and your girl Fanny Longo,
and we are Fanny and Jessy. So right about now, we're gonna do another reaction video. But before we get into the reaction, I wanna say thank you to everyone out there who've been subscribing. You're the realest MVP. This one is, I think, this is part two that we're doing. Yeah,
continuation.
Yeah, it's the continuation of priests and
preachers
entering Islam by Yusuf Estes, something like that. So without any further ado, guys, let's get it.
On. And 2,000 years from now, somebody said, well, that is the Quran. That'd be a joke, wouldn't it? Wouldn't that be a joke? Well, that's pretty much what they got. Somebody writing about it. But it's not the speech of Allah. Next, we got off the subject because I see I'm not going anywhere with that. Next, another night. We're going to talk about what we believe. Because, after all, Christianity is the easiest religion in the world. There isn't anything easier than Christianity. You just say the magic words, you don't have to pray. You don't have to fast. You don't have to make hajj. You don't have to pay zakah. You don't have to grow a beard. You don't have to wear a hijab. You don't have to do anything. Except hope that it's going to work. You gotta hope that God is really going to punish somebody else for your sins so you don't get punished. Not too likely, is it? So, I decided to talk about this. In explaining him about salvation, we came to a new subject. He said, how do you get saved? What will save you from going to hell? I said, well, that's what Christianity is best at. We have the perfect salvation. We have the grace. He said, how does it work? I said, well, the grace works like this. God can't forgive sins, so he sends his son to die for everybody's sin. He said, why can't God forgive sin? Well, I don't know how that works. He said, and if he can't forgive sin, then how come after he kills his son, he can forgive sins? I don't know how that works either. He said, and you're guilty, but his son is innocent. So where in history do we find it that it's good that innocent people have to be killed for the sake of the guilty ones? Well, I don't know how that works either. So we had a problem with that one. Especially when you consider, if your child is bad, really bad, maybe he did something to the cat, maybe he threw stuff out of the refrigerator, ran around the house on a skateboard, broke the television set, broke some windows, maybe let the car roll out into the street and get hit by the trash truck. So you come home and you said, look what he did. But I can't forgive him. So I've got my other child over here that didn't do anything at all. So I'll beat him up. No, I'll kill him. The innocent one. People would put that man in the insane asylum, wouldn't they? They'll lock that man up for that, right? Society won't accept that, so why does religion accept it? And if you accept that, then it should be okay for people to kill their innocent children. But Islam forbid the killing of innocent children. It forbid it because some of the ignorant Arabs used to do that. Kill their innocent children, especially their daughters. Islam forbids the killing of the innocent. Whoops. Well, I had to stop on that one. Let's back off of that. Well, forget about the Bible. Forget about the salvation. That doesn't work. He said, especially when you talk about salvation in Islam, we also say what you say. You say nobody is saved except by grace. That was everything we knew in Texas. I heard that so many preachers said, nobody is saved except by grace. He said the word for grace in Arabic is rahma. And the Quran begins with rahma. Bismillahir Rahman Rahim. Yes? How many times Allah says Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim throughout the Quran? Too many times. So many times Allah talks about Rahmah. And Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, talked about Allah's Rahmah. So much Rahmah. One of the hadiths he talks about that Allah has 100 parts of Rahmah. And one part of the 100 was used for all of mankind and all of his dunya. One part. All the mercy you ever saw or ever imagined since the beginning to the end is one part of Allah's Rahmah. The other 99 parts is waiting for the believers on the Day of Judgment. And the Prophet said, peace be upon him, nobody is saved except by this rahmah. They said, even you, Rasulullah. He said, even me. So who has the grace? Okay, let's get off of that subject. I'm thinking we'll move to something else. He says, can you talk to me about your belief in God? What do you believe about God? God is one. He said, do you have Trinity? Yes, God is three. He said, I thought you said he's one. He is one and three. He said, how does that work? Because God can do anything? Okay, let me get back to you. So I go to my friend with the cross. Remember him? He's out of the hospital. I go to him. I start to tell him the problem I'm having with the Muslims. He said, stay away from them. I told you. I said, yeah, but they believe in Jesus was a miracle birth and Jesus was, you know, doing miracles and Jesus is with God. He's coming back. He said, but they don't believe in the cross. They don't believe in the salvation. I said, well, yeah, but he said, stop. Stay away from them. I said, all I have to do is explain the Trinity. And I'm sure I'll get him there. But how can I explain that one equals three? He said, no, 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 no. Look, it's like an apple. The apple has a skin. Inside of the skin is the meat, and inside of that is the seeds. Three things, one apple, same way, Father, Son, Holy Ghost, one God. Father, Son, Holy Ghost, one God. Got it, okay, got it. So, I go back and I'm ready. Clear off all the dishes after supper. Sit down, my father, myself, my wife, the priest, and the Muslim. Pull out the apple. See this apple? Has a skin. Inside is the meat, and inside of that is the seeds. He said, yeah, there's about six or eight seeds in there. What is that equal? Yeah. Okay. He said, and looks like a worm crawling through it too. That could be four or five gods here. So, all right, let me get back to you. I'm going to go back to the guy with the cross the next day. I said, okay. The apple didn't work. He said, stay away from this guy. I said, the apple didn't work. I told him what happened. He said, it's not, forget about the apple. I said, okay, I forgot about it. It's like an egg. God is like an egg. Alhamdulillah. He said, the egg is a shell. Inside of the shell is the white. Inside of the white is the yellow. Three things, one egg. Said, yes. Now I'm ready. Go back. Clear the table. Sit down. Here we go. See this egg? Yeah, it's a pretty big egg. What if it's a double yolk? God just becomes four. And what if it's rotten? Ooh. Yeah, okay, forget about that. A few days later, I was in a parking lot, some people talking to me, I was preaching as usual, and fella said to me, what's the problem? I was telling him some difficulties with these Muslims. I said, I'm trying to explain the Trinity to this guy and I just can't seem to catch it. He said, don't you know how to do it? You're a preacher, you ought to know that. I said, yeah, I ought to, but I don't have it. He said, look, see me? I'm one person. I said, yes, you are. See my wife right there? I said, yeah, she's one person. Yes, she is. You see my son right there? Yes, he's one person. They're one. But all together, we're a family of three. One family. It's the family of God. I said, that's it. Here we go. But on the way back, I got to thinking about it. I said, let me try to process this before I get there and wind up with apple or egg on my face. I said, okay. The father, the mother, the son. What if they have another kid? What if they have talam, twins? What if they get divorced? Talak. Because in Texas, when you get divorced, the woman, she gets the house, the car, the savings, the bank account, the retirement, the IRS, everything, and your computer and all your email. I don't want a God that could lose his email. I'm trying to think how I'm going to explain this. So I sat down at the table that night and I didn't have a clue, but we're going to try something. I'm trying to explain. The Bible said, actually, the Bible said God is one. Everywhere I look in the Bible, it says God is one. There's nothing except ones. Throughout the whole Bible, there's no Trinity, there's no two, there's no three. There's just one God. Say, O Israel, the Lord your God is one Lord. That's in the book of Deuteronomy and it's in the book of Mark. That means the Old Testament and the New Testament both. The Jews and the Christians are ordered to believe that God is one. Like this. Besides, who wants a God with a worm in it? Or a God that can be rotten, or a God that gets a divorce. So we asked the Muslim, what do you guys say about God? Look what he said. A'udhu billahi min shaitanir rajim. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim.
Okay, you know, sometimes if it's really hard for me to understand the... I get it what he was trying to say. The Christians, they have one God, but again they say that there's, you know, the Holy Trinity, which is three, the Son, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
But don't you think, sorry to disturb, hope you don't lose your point, but what I'm saying, don't you think we're three? Don't you think you're three? Because you're made up of you yourself plus your two parents.
Yeah, you can say, yeah. I mean, you can reason like that. It's really hard to actually explain that. Okay, now, if we come to a conclusion that, okay, God is one, but in God there are three things. There is the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. You know? So, meaning there is the ultimate God, and then there's us. That's what you're trying to say.
What, the example I gave?
But again, when you say that, the Muslim will be like, no, there's only one God. You know, God is not divided into three or what. There's only one God, which is, you know, Allah, which is everything. I don't know, or something like that. But now, I don't know, for me, man, I don't know. I feel like I don't like labels. I just... The idea of God is just one, the ultimate, you know, the universe, the, you go out there, when you see the trees, whatnot, the living things, that's God right there, you understand? But this thing of saying the Spirit, the Son, no, sorry, I mean the Holy Spirit, the Son, and the Father, I really fail to really understand, unless there is a way that someone can explain to me in a very, very, very layman's language. You understand? So I tend to agree with him, but again, I'm not the type that I want to be in that debate where, okay, the Christian God is that and the Muslim God is that. I don't know. For me, I feel like it's more still one God. At the end of the day, maybe Christians, they use some a particular thing to get to God, you know. A particular, let's say they use maybe Mary, or maybe Jesus, and all this kind of stuff. I mean, to get to the ultimate God. Is it not the same way with Muslims that use Muhammad?
They don't.
They don't, yeah.
But then
they
go.
You see.
So I think. Talk to God.
Yeah, so I think that's the difference. So in Christianity, there's like a, what do you call, middleman. You understand? Which the Muslims don't look at it, I mean, in the right way, you understand? But again, maybe Christians.
That's why it's important to have something in the first language.
Yeah.
Because I think the Bible in the first language would better explain what all this confusion is about. And this thing, if the Trinity is not in the Bible, where on earth did people get it? Where did that Trinity thing of saying the Son, Holy Spirit and all that come from?
I think it's more like cosmic. It's more like astrology.
Because I don't understand how... kind of stuff. I really don't get it. Cause then Christians are justified for praying to the Son. Do you understand? If I have to pray to Jesus, then yes, there's a reason as to why. Anyway, it just doesn't make sense. I would love to believe that there's only one God, though. One God is enough. Other things just complicate the situation, and I feel like, I don't know. Complications just hold us back.
When you start talking about religion and this other religion, you'll understand that there's one common factor that joins us together. You know, we all pray to one God. But now...
Not everyone will agree with that.
But now...
Because someone in the comments or someone out there is watching this and saying, no, you pray to Jesus. But not every Christian actually prays to Jesus. Do you understand?
Yeah, but I mean, the main... The common understanding between all religions is that we pray to God. Do you understand? It's only that there are different ways of channeling yourself to that God. Do you understand? So I feel like this kind of debate will never ever end until probably everyone comes to an understanding that, hey, you know what, we've been debating, but what if we're just doing all these things and none of these things exist?
I'm sure there's someone out there thinking that.
Some other people are thinking of like, what if we're fighting each other just to prove ourselves that our religion is the best? What if towards the end we find out that, you know, we were playing ourselves?
Or having a what if is better than just agreeing with what someone tells you.
Because this thing sometimes is just so it's so deep too. It's really hard to understand, you know, because no one knows. It's just a belief. It's just like when you're born and you're told there's God here, so then there's Christianity, Muslim and all this kind of thing. I mean, no one's seen. No one. But I think that other than seeing, I mean, you can be able to tell, or you can be able to feel, you understand, inside yourself. I believe that we were made out of His image or something. I think that's what the Bible says. You get it? So you think that God looks like us?
Going deep. You're going into something else.
You know, now cows, let's say for example, animals. Like,
we still have a long way to go.
For example, like a cow. A cow thinks like its creator is a cow also.
Let us know what you guys think. What's your take on this topic. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and of course, don't forget to subscribe, and we'll see you in our next reaction video.
Deuces.